what is it called? Candid?
Mm-hmm.
Candid is a way of life for me.
I am no good sitting down.
String mandolin. Is a mandolin always 8 strings?
Yeah.
Did not know that.
The strings are
about this mandolin.
It's 103 years old.
The Gibson.
Isn't that beautiful?
1917.
I always wanted a Gibson.
Is that when they like first started making the sound?
Yeah, it was called the Gibson. This is the Gibson. A sweet old tailpiece too.
Look at that.
Engraved there. They get it.
So the old boy that gave you that, he's still alive?
Yeah, he had, you know, the, like you said, no coincidences. I had been walking to my car with all my gear probably 5-6 days a week, and a preacher that grew up in the neighborhood two doors down came over and said, I see you carrying all those guitars and your bass. Do you have a mandolin? I said, yeah, I do. My wife gave me one for Christmas. He said, you ever play a really old Gibson? I said, yeah, I love them. He said, why don't you come into the house for a minute? I have one that my aunt left me. My boys play some, but none of us play that much. Would you play it? And he pulled it out from under the bed, the original case, 1917, the Gibson. Bloody and he pulled out, and you could tell, man, it was like it was played by Willie Nelson for 60 years.
Don't touch it. Ah.
Yeah.
Wait, Willie?
Well, it's 1917. Signed inside and all dated, and he said, you know what, why don't you just take it and play it? I'd rather it be played than just sit under our bed. And I said, man, I'll get you footage of anything I do. I'll give you a copy of every CD I ever play it on. This dude's got a library now of, you know, a whole shelf of things that his precious mandolin is on.
Free.
And that's the story of this beautiful babe that I get to play with my friend.
What a great story, huh?
And scene.
Okay, I'm gonna roll.
Now I'm gonna keep tuning. Yeah, I tune. Sometimes I'll just tune to the track and. That last session was like, okay, well, it's not really A440, is it, guys?
The guy.
There you go.
It's sold out because they didn't have amps back then. They just said, well, let's put an arch top on it and an oval hole, and they'll be asking you to play quieter.
Not you.
I'm going to that E. Oh, man, I've been waiting months to play Seven Spanish Angels with you, brothers. But whatever comes up.
Okay, so we're gonna warm up. We're gonna surprise my general manager here. His name is Mr. Saxon. He's a true European gentleman, and I've taken him into my heart as a very good friend. And here we go. So this hotel we're staying in is the Millennium Baltimore and Biltmore, but the architecture's got, every inch of it has got angels all over it. So. A gentleman downstairs, a doorman, his name is Leo, and he told me a story about someone said there's 10,000 angels in the architecture, so we're going to add 7 more to it.
Hey.
In the paintings and the walls and the friezes, even in the bar, there's 2 angels above the bar, and it's like such an inspiration. So here's a song. You look down into her brown eyes and say, say a prayer for me. Threw her arms around him, whispered, God will keep us free. They could hear the rider's command. He said, this is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive. There were 7 Spanish angels at the altar of the sun, praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. Heaven's Spanish angels took another. down to pick the gun up that lay smoking in his hand. He said, "Father, please forgive me, but I can't make it without my man." That's him. The gun was empty. Come on, she could not win. Nice jump in there, boy.
I forced all myself.
Right.
Class.
One last song and then we're going to roll. You ready? It's a short one. It's a Bobby Dylan song.
Did you do a new video, babe? Let's do a new one.